关于马斯克质问 BBC 说谎这个视频呢，我做过一期，但是在管管上有朋友好像我不知道他是真不明白还是假不明白，就是他说我不太理解你在怎么评论这件事儿的。其实我上次我觉得我给的结论也挺简单的，也不怎么深奥。这个哥们儿是为难我呀，还是他确实是真诚的问这个问题？我也不清楚。那好了，说现在这个视频出来了，我只好再做一遍啊，听听他俩怎么辩论的啊。
Sacks that used to be in content moderation, we've spoken to people very recently who were involved in moderation, and they just say there's not enough people to police this stuff, particularly around hate speech in the company. Is that
What
something that
hate
you want
speech are
to
you talking
address?
about? I mean, you use Twitter.
Right.
Do you see a rise in hate speech?
I mean,
But just a personal anecdote, like what do you do? I don't.
Personally, my for you, I would see I get more of that kind of content, yeah, personally. But I'm not going to talk to the rest of for the rest of Twitter.
So you
But
see more hate
personally,
speech personally?
I would see more hateful content in that.
Content you don't like or hateful? What do you mean to describe a hateful thing?
Yeah, I mean, just content that will solicit a reaction, something that may include something that is slightly racist or slightly sexist, those kinds of things.
So you think if something is slightly sexist, it should be banned?
No,
Is that what you're saying?
I'm not saying anything. I'm
Well, I'm just
saying.
curious. I'm trying to understand what you mean by hateful content, and I'm asking for specific examples. And you just said that if something is slightly sexist, that's hateful content. Does that mean that it should be banned?
Well, you've asked me whether my feed, whether it's got less or more. I'd say it's got slightly more.
That's why I'm asking for examples. Can
Right.
you name one example?
I honestly don't need. Honestly, I
You
don't.
can't name a single example.
I'll tell you why, because I don't actually use that for you feed anymore because I just don't particularly like it.
But you
And
said
actually,
you.
a lot of people are quite similar.
Well,
I only look at
hang on a
my
second. You
following.
said
My
you've seen
following.
more hateful content, but you can't name a single example, not even one.
I'm not sure I've used that feed for the last 3 or 4 weeks, and
Well, then
I
how
think
did
if
you see the hateful content?
because I've been using Twitter since you've taken it over for the last 6 months.
Okay, so then you must have at some point seen that you for you hateful content. And I'm asking for one example.
Right.
And you can't give a single one.
And I'm saying
I say, sir, that you don't know what you're talking about.
Really?
Yes, because you can't give me a single example of hateful content, not even one tweet. And yet you claimed that the hateful content was high.
Well,
That's a false.
no. What I
You just
claimed
lied.
what no no what I claimed was there are many organizations that say that that kind of information is on the rise. Now, whether it has on
Give
my
me one
feed or
example.
not, I mean, right, and
Literally
if you
can't
look at
name
something
one.
like the Strategic Dialogue Institute in the UK, they will say that. So
Look, people will say all sorts of nonsense. I'm literally asking for a single example, and you can't name one.
Right, and as I already said, I don't use that feed. But
Well, then how would you know that
I don't think this is getting
you
anywhere.
literally said you experienced more hateful content and then couldn't name a single example?
Right, and as I said,
That's absurd.
I haven't actually looked at that feed, I
Then
would
how
say,
would
for
you
a
know that it's
few
hateful
weeks.
content?
Because I'm saying that's what I saw a few weeks ago. I can't give you an exact example. Let's move on. We only have a certain amount of time.
Wow.
COVID misinformation.
Amazing.
You changed the COVID misinformation
Has
rules.
BBC changed its COVID misinformation?
The BBC does not set the rules on Twitter, so I'm asking you.
No, I'm talking about the BBC's misinformation about COVID.
I'm literally asking you about you changed the labels, the COVID misinformation labels. There used to be a policy, and then disappeared. Why do that?
Okay, COVID is no longer an issue. Does the BBC hold itself at all responsible for misinformation re regarding ma masking and side effects of vaccinations and not reporting on that at all? And what about the fact that the BBC was put under pressure by the British government to change its editorial policy? Are you aware of that?
This is not an interview about the BBC,
Oh, you thought it
so.
wasn't?
I see now why you've done Twitter Spaces. I am not a representative of the BBC's editorial policy. I want to make that clear. Let's talk about something else. If you want
I'm
to talk about the
interviewing you
BBC,
too.
all right. Let's talk about something else.
You weren't expecting that.
Let's talk about something else. Who have been sacked that used to be in content moderation and
其实这段谈话内容我也不知道是翻译的水平怎么样，因为我也自己不懂英语，但是我觉得这两个人似乎在抢话锋，也就是在抢话语的主动权啊。那记者呢就想和埃隆·马斯克呢谈这个推特上这个语言的暴力啊。埃隆·马斯克呢就想啊把这个节奏引到最后，引到这个 BBC 是个撒谎的机构，你屈服了你们的政府。记者呢就不想跟他这个节奏，他两个是在搞这个东西。我觉得这里面似乎是最后马克龙被弄到了下风。这段话如果懂英语的兄弟们可以认真的分析一下他这段话，当然还有前后的话也一起要放上来才能理解他俩在干啥。我实话实说，我不知道他俩这段对话是什么意思，没有得出结论来。似乎记者在质问埃隆·马斯克的东西，埃隆·马斯克呢不回答他质问这个东西，在跟人家胡搅蛮缠。我觉得马斯克有点胡搅蛮缠。我们的这个官媒呢，好像就是逮住了，说埃隆·马克思说了，说你这个 BBC 撒谎，似乎他的谈话技术也是体现在这里，也死乞白赖。你不问我推特有问题吗？我还问你们那个老板也有问题，有点这个意思，当然，我想要说什么呢？就是没有人有真理，谁说出来的话也不是真理，完全的正确呀，完全的善呢，这个理性就是完全的真理吗？就是完全的事实，这个是做不到的啊。那个搞哲学的都认为，你在叙述的时候，你就要增加，你不由自主的，你无意识的或者你有意识的就要加你的个人偏好，对事实的描述你也会加偏好，或者我也会加偏好，对感性的描述或者这个事情判断是善是恶也会加入自己的偏好，它就不是原本的事实。我们没办法知道谁说的是个真相，谁说的是个假话，谁说的恶言恶语，谁说的是个善良的话。但是我们能可以知道的就是，没有人可以说出真理的话，可以说出至善的话。那怎么办呢？那就要允许大家都说，说完了呢，相互的批驳，不停的批驳呢，不停的博弈呢，就是不停的接近真相。也就是这个，哇，你能得到什么结论？你说这个马斯克质疑这个 BBC 质疑的就是真理。要小心，他们有回马枪啊，是吧？你进入这个节奏，你跟不上他的节奏，他的回马枪扎的你也够难受啊，会扎住你。可能就是这个，东西吧，挺精彩的，可能这段对话，但是我没办法获得，更多的一些个信息。我觉得就是两个人在抢夺话语权而已。我说我的，他说他的，这个记者呢，就是总不着他的道儿，总别纠缠这个问题，我们进行下一个问题。不行，马斯克好像是败了，就抓住这个问题不放，那不胡搅蛮缠吗？人记者已经有过几次，就是说，这个问题别纠缠了，我们继续谈别的问题。从这点要看呢，这个马斯克是处于下风了。好了。那个质疑我的那个朋友，我就告诉你，没有人能说出至善的话，也没有能说出真理的话。我们需要不同的声音人成年人的世界嘛，需要不同的声音。说这个人动机是什么？说诛心论这个问题其实马斯克是在用诛心论人家记者在说事实，说你推特上有仇恨的言论是这些个东西，你怎么管理的？马斯克就说让你举个例子，那还不好举吗？推特上。这么大的信息量，你让记者给你举这样例子，你好举吗？是吧？但是这个东西都是很感性的东西，是吧？他举出来说这个是，仇恨言论，他就说不是，你这个不扯皮吗？那你推特上肯定是有仇恨言论的，是吧？马斯克是胡搅蛮缠，在这里有一点。 啊。那么这个诛心论呢，就是有诛心论的应用技巧啊，我觉得是有它的所谓的向善逻辑和向恶逻辑。对于弱者呢，就是尽量慎用诛心论，对于强者是必须要用诛心论啊。很多